Dear friends, welcome back. In this video, we learn how to build a dark activated light. When the light disappears, the LED goes on. It's a very easy project, so let's start. The parts needed in order to build this project are these: a 2N3904 NPN transistor, a photoresistor. We need a 2K resistor and 100 ohm resistor for the LED, and of course a bright LED. We also need 4 AA batteries in order to power the project. Of course, this project can work with other parts as well. For example, you can use any NPN transistor you like, or another combination of resistors and input voltage. Before connecting all the parts together, let's see how the transistor works in this particular project. In this project, the transistor works as a digital switch. If we push a small amount of current to its base, the middle leg, the transistor switches on. So a big amount of current can flow from this leg to this leg, from collector to emitter. So what we want to do is to turn on the transistor when it is dark. When the transistor turns on, the current can flow through it and the LED turns on. If there is no current to transistor's middle leg, the transistor is off, so it won't let current flow through it, so the LED is off as well. So we are going to use the photoresistor in order to turn the transistor on or off. Now let's connect all the parts together. We connect all the parts according to the circuit diagram. First, we connect the transistor. This is the collector, the base, and the emitter. According to the diagram, we connect the collector to 5V, so we connect it to breadboard plus. Next, we connect the 2K resistor to breadboard plus as well. According to the diagram, you can replace it with a trim pot if you like. Next, we connect the photoresistor from the base to ground. Next, we connect the 100 ohm resistor for the particular LED that we are using. The long leg of the LED connects to the resistor and the other one to ground. Now we connect power, and as you can see, the project is working. If I cover the photoresistor with my hand, the LED goes on, and when I remove it, the LED goes off. Let's now see in detail how the circuit works. When it is day, the photoresistor has a very low resistance, lower than the base emitter resistance of the transistor. So the current, when it has two paths to choose from, it will choose the path with the least resistance. In this case, it will choose the path from the photoresistor. Only a tiny amount of current will go through the transistor, less than the value required to turn the transistor on. So it will remain off, and the LED will remain off as well. If it is night, the photoresistor has a huge resistance, so the current will try to avoid it. So it will choose the path through the transistor, which now has less resistance than the photoresistor. The amount of current that is flowing through the base of the transistor is enough to turn the transistor on. So a big amount of current will flow from collector to emitter, and that current flow will turn the LED on. As you can see, with the use of a few parts, we can build a quite interesting device. If you understand how this project works, you have gained a basic understanding of how transistors work as well. I believe that true knowledge only comes by doing, so I encourage you to build this project if you want to better understand transistors and photoresistors. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post do-it-yourself hardware and software projects every Saturday. I believe that knowledge and know-how must be shared to as many people as possible. Together we can make impressive things. By combining our skill sets, we can improve our lives. I encourage you to join our community and post your ideas in the comment section below. I would love to hear you. The next video will be posted online at the first Saturday of September. I am taking a few weeks off. So, I wish you the best, and I will see you in September with more exciting projects. Bye!